Before we start the video, guys, you guys know that you can get a free month of Envato Elements in the link below. If you've watched this channel or if you're a video editor, you probably know what Envato Elements is. It's a pretty good deal. Check it out. Every subscription helps the channel. All right, let's get into this video. How's it going, guys? Joshua Lefemi here, live from LA. We have a new camera setup that we're sporting here, and we also have the Wacom Intuos Pro tablet. They just sent this to me. We're actually going to be using this today for this video. This is actually one of my first times using this tablet. We're gonna see how it goes. In this video, we're gonna be talking about a specific music video style called the Dream Look and how it's being used really well in this music video by Rayma called Ginger Me, directed by director Sei and produced by Maven Records, founded by the amazing Don Jazzy. Shout out to all y'all over there. We're actually gonna be using Frame.io, which is a really cool browser-based way that you can like leave notes and draw on every frame of any video that you upload to it. We're then gonna be using the Wacom tablet to actually do those drawings as opposed to using my mouse. All right, guys, it's time to get into the Dream Look. When I'm talking about the dream look for a music video style, I'm usually associating it with three main descriptors: past memories, soft, and vintage. I'm now gonna be talking about seven specific aspects of the video that match each of those descriptors and that make up, in this case, the dream look. All right, let's start the video. So the first thing I'm gonna talk about are these things called scene teases. These are scenes that you're gonna see a lot more of in the later half of the video, but they're only teased at the beginning. You only see them in short little snippets. What I feel like this kind of represents is the fact that memories of dreams, or maybe even just memories in general, they often come in like snapshots that are hard to remember in full episodes. It's a cool way to start out a video because it's a cool way to just foreshadow that there's something to come. This is not the first time that you see this phenomenon of scene teases in music videos. I remember a music video that comes to mind is For the Road by Tyga featuring Chris Brown, directed by the amazing Colin Tilley. He used scene teases a ton. In both of these videos, you kind of have your main stable anchor footage being teased by somewhat contrasting, crazy, fantastical silhouetted footage that's just a whole different style with the flashing lights and the crazy dancing. It's a cool contrast, it keeps things interesting. The next shots we're gonna talk about are the shots where they used a tilt shift lens, and I'm gonna show you a little bit what that means. It's basically a lens, it's a special lens that basically blurs the top and the bottom. Sometimes it blurs the sides, and it kind of just focuses your attention towards the middle of the shot. You see these lenses used a lot during in photography that's used to try to mimic miniatures. So say you're shooting a shot of a city with a lot of cars from a drone. A lot of the time you'll use a tilt shift lens to actually make that shot look like it's a miniature set with a lot of toy cars driving on a fake road. It's crazy how the tilt shift lens kind of gives you that surreal miniature look just by blurring the top and the bottom or the sides. In this case, I feel like the DP used the tilt shift lens to kind of mimic the limited field of view that you would have when you're in a dream. So I just thought it was a creative little trick that they used to make the video a little bit more interesting and stay in line with this dream look that we're talking about. Next type of shot we're going to talk about are basically most of the shots. You can see that there's an obvious soft like dream filter that's being used. You can see that all the shots are very soft and vintagey looking. They're not sharp or crisp at all, and it's this cool kind of like, it's a soft film look. You can get this look with actual professional dream filters you can put on your lens, or you can do it the DIY way by actually putting like a nylon stocking over your lens. In general, I thought using film burns was kind of a cool way to stay in line with this dream look, because in general, film burns, they're gonna be associated with past memories. Why is that? Well, because if you think about it, old film is gonna automatically be associated with past memories because they represent looking into the past. Any type of footage on old film is gonna be old memories from the past. So it's just a cool unconscious association, I think. Next type of shot we're going to talk about are the slow pans and push-ins. These are cool camera techniques that obviously accentuate beauty shots, but they also signify time slowing down as it would when one is harkening back and focusing on something. Last thing I'll talk about are these awesome vintage star filters that you can see in a lot of these shots. This is just a cool way to kind of harken back to that vintage 70s vibe. It's something that's very easy to do. There are actual filters that you can put over your lens that will completely diffract the light and create these really cool star-shaped lens flares. They're awesome. You should check them out. That's pretty much it, guys. I just really liked how this video looked. It was just a very clean, beautiful video. It was shot in like just two locations. I really liked the song. I really liked Rayma as an artist just in general. When you watch this video, I hope you're not just looking at this as a specific music video breakdown for this specific video, but I hope that you actually look at the dream look as something that you can maybe implement in your own videos as well, because that's all it is. It's a style that can be replicated in so many different ways. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Thank you so much, Sei, for creating this awesome video. Thank you, Wacom, for giving me this tablet that I'm still figuring out how to use. I'm hoping to eventually get to the point where I'm completely replacing my mouse and just using the tablet for everything, video editing. It's gonna be awesome when that happens. Of course, you know that you can get Envato Elements for free in the link below, another great channel sponsor. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and as always, remember to keep it chill.